Welcome to Your Miraculous Life. I'm your host, Dr. Kynan Bridges, and it is my earnest prayer and desire that you would encounter the tangible presence of God. In fact, I believe that your life will never be the same. Can I pray with you? Father, I thank you for all those watching. May they have an encounter with you that will transform their lives, and may they never be the same. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. On today's conversation, we're going to talk about something that is very controversial, yet necessary, a very necessary discussion, and it is breaking the curse of poverty. I believe that millions of people are living under the thumb of poverty. They are, in fact, living under a curse. And we're going to show you, number one, how to recognize a curse, and number two, how to break a curse so that you can actually live in the life God intends for you. Before we get into breaking the curse, we must first define what a curse is. When we talk about a curse, we're talking about a solemn utterance that is made to invoke supernatural powers to do harm or evil. Another way to describe the word curse is an imprecation of evil. The Bible says in Galatians chapter 13, Galatians chapter 3, verses 13 and 14, that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, as it is written, cursed is everyone that hangs upon the tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon us through Jesus Christ. So the Bible says that Christ has redeemed us, or he has paid the penalty for the curse that we were all condemned to. In fact, Christ was our substitutionary sacrifice. He was our ransom sacrifice that stood in the place of us as sinners. He was a sinless sacrifice that stood in our stead and took the punishment and the wrath of God on himself in our place. This is a profound reality. Another place it talks about how Jesus Christ became poor so that we through his poverty might be made rich. Jesus became poor so that we through his poverty would become rich. So when I talk about the thumb of poverty, I want you to understand, poverty, write this down, poverty is not a financial status. It is a spiritual reality. Poverty is not a financial status. It is a spiritual reality. It's actually a spiritual condition that affects the way a person thinks, reasons, rations, and behaves. Let me say that again. It is a spiritual curse, a spiritual state that affects the way a person reasons, rations, thinks, and behaves. In other words, you can have a poverty mindset irrespective of what's in your bank account. In fact, I know a bunch of rich folks that have a spirit of poverty. Why? Because poverty is not just about what you have in your bank account, it is the condition of your spiritual life. This is so, so, so important. So the first thing you need to understand is this. How do I identify if there is a curse of poverty operating in my bloodline? Quickly, I want to help you with that. Number one, you need to look at the trajectory of your family. You know, how many in your family have been really successful? How many people have really broken through? How many people have done things like finish their education or been able to buy a house or been able to buy a new car, for example? These are all examples of poverty. And what I mean by that, I'm not trying to condemn anyone who doesn't have those things. I want you to understand something. But if you can look at your family line and you can see that everyone in your family has stayed at a certain level, spiritually, financially, maritally, that can be an indicator that the curse of poverty is actually operating in your bloodline. When everybody that you know is struggling, or you come from a history of struggling, despite how much money you make, despite how much education you have, you're struggling, there could be a bloodline curse operating in your family, specifically the curse of poverty. And when we come back, I'm going to go even deeper, and I want to show you how to not only recognize these curses, but to break these curses so that you can live the life God intends you to live. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Your Miraculous Life.
Are you ready to leave the land of lack and enter God's land of promise? Do you desire to experience biblical prosperity in a tangible way? In this powerful resource bundle, you will receive biblical keys to unlock supernatural abundance in your life. Learn the secrets to overcoming debt and lack. Apply the wisdom of God to experience supernatural increase and break the spiritual stronghold of poverty in your life. Become a destiny helper in the kingdom of God. For your gift of $65 or more, you will receive the Breakthrough Bundle, which includes Dr. Kynan's brand new anointed book, Teach Me How to Prosper, Biblical Keys to Supernatural Abundance. Receive decades of revelation and biblical application packed into one book. You will also receive Dr. Kynan's powerful and insightful book, Releasing Miracles, How to Walk in the Supernatural Power of God. Be equipped to move in signs, wonders, and miracles. You will also receive the Releasing Miracles Anointed Prayer Club. Use this as a point of contact to release your faith for miracles, signs, and wonders. Every prayer club has been prayed over by Dr. Kynan and his team of intercessors. Again, for your gift of $65 or more, we will send you these powerful resources. To receive your gift today, simply call us at 1-800-516-7038. Again, that's 1-800-516-7038. Or visit our website, www.kynanbridges.com, or write us at Kynan Bridges Ministries, P.O. Box 159, Ruskin, Florida 33575. Call now. Prayer partners are standing by. Looking for a church home? We are conveniently located in the heart of Tampa, Florida. Join us Sunday mornings, 10 a.m., Supernatural School of Ministry, Tuesday evenings at 7 p.m., and an hour of breakthrough prayer, Saturday evenings at 6:30 p.m. Join us 6015 Inner Bay Boulevard, Tampa, Florida, 33611. See you soon.
Welcome back to Your Miraculous Life. I'm your host, Dr. Kynan, and I'm so excited that you stayed with us. Listen, I would encourage you right now to go to the phones, 1-800-516-7038. Again, 1-800-516-7038. And we want to pray with you. We want to intercede with you. We have prayer warriors standing by right now. And also, we have some tremendous resources available for you. When you call in, I would encourage you to ask for the resources. We have Teach Me How to Prosper, my brand new book, Biblical Keys to Supernatural Abundance. And we also have a very powerful resource, Releasing Miracles, How to Walk in the Supernatural Power of God. We're going to send this to you as actually a bundle for your gift of $65 or more. We would encourage you again to go to the phones, 1-800-516-7038, or visit the website, KynanBridges.com. You could always write to us at Kynan Bridges Ministries, P.O. Box 159, Ruskin, Florida, 33575. Listen, before the break, we were talking about how to identify whether a curse is operating in your life. How to identify whether a curse is operating in your life. And we talked about how when you see limited success in a bloodline or a limited ability to see abundance manifest in people's lives, that could be a sign that a curse is operating in a person's life. We also talked about before the break, I think this is so key and critical, that another sign, as we were talking about, was the mentality associated with poverty. You know, maybe you're in a family and people just don't want more out of life. They don't want more. They don't want anything better. They're just okay with mediocrity. They're okay with just survival, just barely get along street. And if you talk above that, they get offended. They say, well, why are you doing all of that? We don't need all of that. And so a diminished desire for more can be an indicator that a curse is operating. Now, I want to stop there because we have something very interesting called Ask the Pastor. And this is where we give you an opportunity to ask us questions on social media, particularly Facebook, and we answer those questions live on the air. I have a question from a young lady named Cell. And she says, why are people afraid of prosperity? Why are people afraid of prosperity? Well, Cell, that's a great question. And I want to use that question as a segue into the next portion of the teaching. I want you to understand that not only is poverty about diminished vision, a lack of expectancy for more, it could be a lack of success or progress, but it's also manifest in people believing that poverty is somehow a badge of honor. There was something called the vow of poverty, popularized in the 6th and 7th century, that basically stated that in order to be close to God, one had to be poor. In other words, the poorer you are, the more spiritual or closer to God you are. The poorer you are, the more spiritual or closer to God you are. Nothing could be further from the truth. Your closeness to God has nothing to do with you being broke. And I believe that this is really a misapplication and an improper understanding of what Jesus said when he said, blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are the poor in spirit. He wasn't talking about people who are in debt, who can't pay their bills. He wasn't talking about people that struggle financially. He's talking about people that are humble. And so once we understand that the vow of poverty is actually from hell and not heaven, we can know that it is God's will for us to prosper. In fact, in that moment, we are liberated from the fear of prosperity. We don't have to be afraid to prosper because it is God's will for our lives. 3 John 2, beloved, I wish above all things that you would prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. Man, there's so much I want to give you, but don't go anywhere. We'll be right back in just a moment, and I'm going to go even deeper and activate you in prosperity. We'll be right back. Friends, I am so grateful that you stay with us this time. And I believe that God's going to do something supernatural in your life. He's going to transform your life for the glory of God. And I would encourage you right now to release your faith for more. I believe that generational curses of lack, poverty, and debt are being broken. You are the Joseph to your generation. You're the one God has anointed to hear this message and to take it to the ends of the earth to effect change in your family. Would you go to the phones, 1-800-516-7038. Again, 1-800-516-7038. We want to pray with you. We have prayer warriors standing by who will intercede, who will walk you through prayers of deliverance and breakthrough, and who will encourage you, friends. I'm telling you, something good is happening for you right now. Listen, when you go to the phones, make sure to ask for our resource offer, Teach Me How to Prosper, Biblical Keys to Supernatural Abundance, along with Releasing Miracles, How to Walk in the Supernatural Power of God. I'm telling you, and we're going to send you also our anointed prayer cloth that I believe will literally be a point of contact to release your faith. Again, go to the phones, 1-800-516-7038. Would you consider being a YML Connection partner? For your substantial generosity, we want to connect with you, keep you up to date on different events, things that we have going on, but also you will know that you are a part of advancing the kingdom of God to millions of people all over the world. Every week, we broadcast to hundreds of millions of people, and it's because of your love and generosity. Friends, I want to pray with you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we break every curse of poverty, lack, and debt, and we declare that generational strongholds of poverty are absolutely destroyed by the power of the blood in Jesus' name. The ultimate poverty is not having a relationship with Jesus Christ. And if you don't know the Messiah, I want to pray with you right now. Just say this prayer after me. Say, Heavenly Father, I believe that Jesus Christ is your Son. He suffered on the cross and died. He defeated Satan. He was raised again on the third day, and he is now seated at your right hand, praying for me so that I can have an abundant life. Lord Jesus, I surrender to you. I repent of my sins, known and unknown. I ask that you would come into my heart, cleanse me, wash me in your blood, and make me a new creature. Fill me with your Holy Spirit so that I can live a life pleasing to you. If you pray that prayer, in Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer, I believe that your life will never be the same again. You are not only on your way to heaven, but God says, I'm going to manifest heaven in earth by faith. And I want you from this moment forward to begin to study and meditate on the word of God so that your life can be transformed. Listen, go to the phones, 1-800-516-7038. We want to pray with you, encourage you, and want you to connect with us because we believe that something good is about to happen in your life. Friends, as always, it's always a pleasure to talk with you, to meet with you right here on Your Miraculous Life. And I believe your life is going to a new dimension in God. Prosperity is yours. Shalom, and until next time, remember, Jesus is Lord. God bless.